Listen, I'm going to pull a surprise on you out of my pocket.
Oh, boy.
I hope I have it with me. Oh, my God. Oh, no, it's on the table. All right. Listen, I'm going to tell you what my 10 best films of the year are, if you don't mind.
I would love to hear them.
And you can react.
Okay.
Like you're interested.
I am interested. I've got to see a few, but...
Because understudies, we have to say, your time is just all taken up. I mean, you're just in that theater all the time, and then when it's performing, I mean, you have to be there, right?
Yeah, I check in and I stay every day. And
stay through the whole... I know my friend Dari Lawrence. Hello, Dari, again. She stays and goes to her dressing room and stays for the whole show, Dead Accounts, with Katie Holmes. I and Norbert Leo Butz, I thought it was hilarious. Anyway, my number 10 best film of 2012 was... The Deep Blue Sea.
Didn't see that. Who was that with?
Okay, Rachel Weisz is in it, giving us an astounding performance. It was a British film, a small British film that I saw 2 years ago at the Toronto Film Festival.
Okay.
Just came out in March, based on a Terence Rattigan play that has been completely rethought of by Terence Davies, who was on the show twice, you remember, and Tom Hiddleston, who's become this big star, with the Avengers. He was the bad guy.
Oh, that's right.
In the Avengers. Anyway, it was a beautiful, touching film.
Deep Blue Sea, number 10.
Yes. Thank you, Matthew. You're good at this. I thought you would be. That's why I decided to surprise you with this, you know, ragged envelope of 5 years, 10 best. Number 9 is Beasts of the Southern Wild. Did you see that?
I haven't. I heard that's great. That's on my... What a breakout film.
Mm-hmm.
Who was that director?
Ben Zeitlin, who's been on the show.
Congratulations, Ben.
With Quvenzhané Wallace as the little black girl in it, Hush Puppy, and her father, Dwight Henry, both of them non-actors before this.
Really?
Was breathtaking, original, heartfelt, about Hurricane Katrina and this little child, this 5-6-year-old girl who is Quvenzhané. I predict... She's going to go on from the... I mean, she's just this incredible natural actress. And mm-hmm. And Ben has said that he wants to continue working with her and writing films in New Orleans for her. She's from New Orleans. And she's just this incredible natural talent. And it's so original and so striking and filmed mostly in the water. You're not supposed to do that. I mean, it's difficult. And Hurricane Katrina, they were emulating... I mean, they were recreating
I'm glad to see projects coming out now that are focusing on that and these kind of...
And it was made for like 12 cents, you know. Yeah. And it could get nominated for Best Picture this year.
When do we find out? When's that coming out?
The Oscar nominations are announced on Thursday, but you'll be seeing this after that. But so right now we're just in a state of anticipation.
Well, you do know this guy is called the Oscar Messenger, so...
It's true.
If you got any pools at your Oscar parties, you throw in a couple bucks... Or watch his show and you'll know the inside.
And you'll be wrong. But anyway, lose a lot of money like I do on the show. Number 8 is Argo. Well, if you're talking about Argo, have you seen Argo?
Mm-mm.
God, you haven't seen anything, man.
I've been working.
Yeah.
You gotta work, man. I know that, but...
Well, he gets all the screeners and free admission to these things. It's
well, I go to see him on the big screen, as I told you that night. And, Historic Night in Green Symphony. Argo is directed by Ben Affleck.
Sure.
It's about the Americans trying to get, who is Ben Affleck in the film, the CIA and everybody trying to get this group of hostages out of the Canadian embassy during the Iran hostage crisis in the 1970s.
Right.
And it's a really, really good suspense thriller as all... Also very funny because they keep cutting back to Hollywood, where they're supposedly the ruse that they're carrying out is that these people who are trapped in the embassy are really a film crew making this science fiction movie called Argo.
Do you think you're going to see a Best Picture nomination for that?
Yes, and that might even win.
Wow.
That might even win.
You heard it here first.
Because... There's such contention for the Best Picture thing, and Argo is something that everybody likes. Nobody doesn't like it. It pleases everyone, and Hollywood saves the day. Directed by Ben Affleck. We love Ben. Yeah, be on the show, Ben.
Artist.
Yeah. And that could be the dark horse. And Liz Smith thinks that's the one that's going to win. But there's lots of competition this year. But that could be the one that everybody likes. Okay, number seven is End of Watch. Jake Gyllenhaal.
Yeah. The LAPD film.
Yeah, the cop drama, Michael Pena, both of whom deserve to be nominated for the Oscars. But I don't think they're going to make it. But hey, we tried. And what a beautiful, surprising, heartfelt film that is about good cops.
Sure. Have you seen Mr. Gyllenhaal in If There Is, I Haven't Found
It? No, I didn't. I missed it.
So did I. That just closed. I hear he's great. He's a great actor.
So, yeah, no, I keep asking you, have you seen it? And he constantly says no. And number six is The Invisible War, which is a doc, and it's about rape in the military. It's by Kirby Dick, and it's a shocker.
All right.
Because all of these women who join the armed forces, almost all of them get raped by the other soldiers.
Almost all. So we're talking more than one and two. We're talking, I mean, this, or at least, I can imagine, at least certainly harassed, assaulted. Doesn't surprise me. What are they doing about it? Anything?
Well, they've made this movie, and they're suing the Army, and it's heavy duty stuff. And Kirby Dick did a wonderful, wonderful job. Very powerful doc. I had to include it. It's the only doc I have in here, however.